All right, three. All the while my breath is in me, and the Spirit of God is my nostrils, he says. All the while my breath is in me, and the Spirit of God is my nostrils, my lips shall not speak wickedness. He's not going to lie. My tongue won't utter deceit. And he said, I'm going to shoot straight no matter what, if it kills me. God forbid that I should justify you till I die. Now, here's what he shouldn't have said. Till I die. Now, this is why God hit him in the first place. Now you get the answer. For God forbid that I should justify you till I die, I will not remove my integrity. Self-righteous. That's what will kill you. Christ is the righteousness of God. He's a good man. He's a great man. But he knew it. And he said, I'm not going to give up my works and my integrity. I'm going to earn my way all the way, and I'm going to make up of my works. And then in the book, the Lord said, no, you ain't. At the end of the book, you know, you want to see a change in the tune. Look at the end of this book. And look what Job says when the Lord finally shows up. Chapter 42, verse 4. You talk about a change of tune. Watch this thing go from what you just read. Verse 4. Hear, I beseech thee, and I will speak. I will demand of thee, and declare thou to me. Talking to God. I have heard of thee by the hearing of the ear, but now mine eye seeth thee. Wherefore, I abhor myself. What happened to his integrity? It blew out the window. He says, I'm no good. I abhor myself. Now, that's right. That's when you get saved. When you realize you can't do it yourself. I abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes. That's a long way from I'll not remove my integrity from me. Long way. Now he's showing you there two kinds of repentance, and they're illustrated by two famous Bible characters. And those characters are Judas and Simon Peter. And those two fellows there, you have what we call evangelical repentance and false repentance. And the world majors in false repentance. I've got to be sorry for my sins. Judas was sorry for his, and he went to hell. I need to confess my sins. Good, Judas confessed his and went to hell. See, the world looks at it, they don't get it. They repent, and they're bitter, and they're sorry because they got caught. And do you believe in restoring something after you did? He did. He restored the money and then went to hell. So you can confess your sins and be sorry for your sins, crying in the chapel, and pay back what you owe to your fellow man, and you do right with him, and then go to hell and still go to hell. You say, why? You don't have perfect righteousness. What's perfect righteousness? It's Jesus Christ. So Christ, when the Holy Spirit has come, he'll convict the world of sin, not because of anything I mentioned there, but because they believe not on me. That's the problem. You take Simon Peter, he comes out a different thing. One guy, after he's doing all that, you know he does? He goes out and hangs himself and goes home to hell. But he repented and confessed and made restitution. That's what every Muslim is counting on to save him, and every Roman Catholic. He's kind of confessing his sins and straightening up and cleaning out and trying to do right, good works to get him to heaven, to go to hell. Repentance is not sorrow just for what you've done. It's sorrow for what you are. Isaiah takes one look and he says, I'm an unclean man, I have an unclean tongue, and dwell in the midst of unclean people. He said, it's me. Peter says, depart from me, Lord, I am a sinful man. That's being sorry for what you are, not for what you do. I remember one time I was preaching in Memphis, Tennessee, and out there in that square park where they got that statue of Forrest. And I had a microphone, I had a pretty little crowd there, 40, 50 people, and drawing for them on one of those bandstands up in the middle of that park. And while I was drawing, I noticed occasionally when I turned back to the board, there was a guy across the street, maybe from here to that window, standing there, kind of a rough-looking character, leaning against a post, and he had a suitcase down here. I just noticed that while I was preaching. I finished preaching, went out and passed out some tracts. And the guy was still across the street, so I wanted to see him. And I said, where are you from? He said, oh, I just heard you say Maymanette. And he said, I'm from Maymanette, Alabama. I said, well, yeah, is that what's your name? He said, well, Jimmy Green. He said, of course, that isn't my real name. But he said, I heard you preach. I said, what'd you do about it? He said, well, you told the truth. He said, I told the truth. Are you going to accept Christ? Have you done that yet? He said, no, I haven't, but I'm going to. Well, how about right now? He said, no, I can't right now. And I said, well, why not? And he said, well, I'll show you why. He said, you know what I got in that suitcase down there? And I said, no, and I don't want to know either. And he said, well, I'd show it to you. I know you ain't going to rat on me. He said, I know what kind of preacher you are. He said, I kind of preaching, I got that back in Bay Minette. So I know you ain't going to tell nobody, for show you. And he went open up. Had about 10 38s in it. He just stole them. His name was Jimmy Green, but that wasn't his real name. And I talked to him for a while, and I said, now, Jimmy, so you know what you'll do? You ought to take that valise you got there. You ought to take that thing and go up the road to the Justice Hall, the town hall right up the hill there, about a half a mile. I said, go in there and go into a lawyer's office or a judge's office and dump that on his desk. And say, my name is Jimmy Green, and I'm getting right with God. And said, I stole these things and I want to give them back. And if I've got to pay for it in prison for a while, I'm going to pray for it, but I'm going to live for God. And I'll bet you they'll let you off the hook. Said, oh, preacher, I'm a three-time loser already. They'd cook my goose. I said, what, did you try it? Why don't you try it? Oh, I've tried everything, preacher. I said, no, you haven't. He said, what ain't I tried? And I said, Jimmy, I said, you never look in a mirror any place in this world, look in there and point your finger right at yourself and said, Jimmy, you ain't no good, and you never been any good, and you ain't ever won me worth a dime. I bet you haven't said that, have you? He said, well, no, I haven't done that. I said, well, that's what you need to do. You what? You repent of not of stealing the stuff. You repent of being the kind of guy that do it.